So today we celebrate the 10-year anniversary of the weekly Laravel newsletter. I've been sending it pretty much every Sunday since 2014. And believe it or not, I still do it by hand for the most part, which I know the developer brain in all of us is like, well, that should be automated. And, you know, I have automated a lot of it, but still, I mean, I still do it manually just because I like to be able to highlight the what I feel like is the lead story for the week. You know, I want to change descriptions, add, you know, bullet points, things like that, that it's just not susceptible to automation. So, you know, I still do it. I still love it. And I'm just, you know, glad that the community seems to get usefulness out of it. So to celebrate this, I want to go through and show you how we create the weekly newsletter. So I've got an example up right here. This is from last week's send. And what we're doing on the back end is we're using an app called Mazel, created by Cosmin and his team. They actually, I work with them to create the different layouts and, you know, get everything set up perfectly. So let's dive into some code and let me show you how this thing works. I've got VS Code open here and it's basically a stock Mazel app. The only thing different is inside the config file. I have it pulling from a few private APIs that I built, and that pulls over, you know, the different sections like the jobs and the community links and the archive, things like that. So that's basically what's in the config directory. But to build the newsletter, we have a source folder, content, and basically we just use markdown files. So you can see 512, that was last week's. Each markdown file has a front matter. And you can see we have weekly here. This just shows you which layout we're using. See, we have daily, weekly, weekly alt, weekly release, alt, weekly release, and then just the standard weekly. The daily is actually not used in this repo, but that one now is an automated email, and it comes out every day at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And that basically shows you everything we publish on the site that day, as well as any community links and any jobs placed. So, you know, if you want a sort of a daily update, you can subscribe to that one as well. I think it's up to about 4,000 subscribers on that one. But the big newsletter, the one we send every Sunday, has everything the weekly or the daily one has. But that one goes out to about, I think it's about 40,000 subscribers now. We still have a 40-50% open rate, which is, to me, that's pretty impressive for doing this for a decade. And we're still having, you know, really good open rates. We're still gaining subscribers. Just shows you the, you know, the power of Laravel and how much Laravel itself is growing. But to kind of show you here, so we run Mazel. You can just run npm run dev, and that will start up the dev server. And from here, all you have to do, let me open the browser, refresh, and let me show you the different templates. So we have weekly here. If we swap to weekly alt, you can see this refreshes and it has a black header. We have weekly release. Refresh that, and that just shows you, you know, it sort of changes the header to the whatever release is out this week. And weekly release alt, which should be a little bit different. So those are basically the four layouts. So each week I try to sort of vary on which one we're sending, but that's how we do that. All right, so let's go down and let me show you the markdown section. So each item is a component. You can see right here in the sidebar, if we go to components, we have a whole bunch of different components here. So the article is the, you know, sort of the main thing. We have a sponsor component, a podcast component for when, you know, Jake and Michael release new podcasts. That way they're automatically in the newsletter. And then down at the bottom, we have some of the API components, which are the jobs, the links, and the archives. And those just sort of get filled in automatically. But from here, what we do is, let me clear this out, npm run, once we're happy, we just run npm run build. We get a npm error, but it still works. And that ends up throwing it into build production. And you can see we have a 512 HTML file. And that one includes all the nasty nested tables and the email CSS and you know, just everything. So that's why Mazel is so powerful, because it takes all that stuff and keeps it away from you when you're writing your emails. And for me, I find it more powerful to write in Markdown versus like a WYSIWYG on the, you know, through some newsletter app. So all I have to do is take this HTML, upload it right to the app I'm using, and then hit send, and it goes out. The only bad thing, you know, writing a newsletter, sending to 40,000 people, and you're doing it by hand, is when mistakes are made. For instance, you know, if I have a misspelling or if something's formatted weirdly, I have thousands of emails coming back to me saying, hey, you know, you messed up here. I do appreciate it. I do appreciate people letting me know, you know, things I've made a mistake on and ways that we can improve. But at the same time, I can't respond to everybody. So if you respond to me and tell me, hey, you made a mistake, just know I probably read it and I'm not going to respond because I have too many of those emails. But the cool part about Mazel 2 is the source archive. So I've been doing this since number 444, Laravel 9.47. So every time I create a new newsletter, I take the one in content, I just move it up, and then start fresh with, you know, number 513 Markdown. So, you know, that's sort of how we build it. Another thing I do to make this a little easier is inside the Laravel News control panel, we're using Filament, and I have a special newsletter page, and that basically puts it into the same format that I need. And then I take this, just copy and paste it over, and usually what I do is just you know, sort of leave all the main stuff the same up here, but you know, swap out this for bullet points, sort of, you know, do things like that. Or maybe even change the title to be a little bit more, you know, scannable or something like that. But that's basically it. So that's how we run a weekly newsletter, and that's how I, you know, build it by hand each week. You know, if you, like I said earlier, if you are looking to start your own newsletter and you want to customize it and make it special, check out Mazel, because, man, that thing saves me so much time and effort, and that team's done a really good job on creating that project. Outside of that, you know, be sure and subscribe to the newsletter if you haven't. You know, if you have, thanks for subscribing, and we will see you next time. Thanks for watching.